Hello, this is Daedalus75 Games. You're watching another Let's Play of Crusader Kings 2. Unfortunately, when I had computer issues and I had to reinstall Windows, like my Windows was just fried. About a month and a half ago, I lost my save of the original game I was playing, Crusader Kings 2, when I was playing the Norse faction, and I was Scandinavia, and I basically had all of Britannia and all of Scandinavia and all of Hispania. Unfortunately, it's been lost. It sucks because I got into the mid-1300s, even the late, I think it was around 1370, so it was pretty close to the end of the game, and I was planning on using that save. I was going to make Iberia go independent, and then be all Norse and independent. They've changed some things now. I mean, this game right now has the latest DLCs. Everything but the customizer, which I don't really need because they already added the customizer in with the Charlemagne DLC. So I've already created my character, and I'm going Iron Man. We are going to be part of Charlemagne's empire, but we will not be Charlemagne. I've created my own character in a spot that is actually very difficult. So we're part of Charlemagne's empire. It's West Francia, and there's Middle Francia. It is the year 769, so it's 98 years earlier than the start for the Viking expansion, the DLC. So no, we are Christian this time. Saxony is pagan to the north. Bavaria is Christian, and Bohemia, Sorbia, and all these, this is all Slavic pagan. So I'm a little concerned about this, because in my last, like, this is my third playthrough. I've been testing out, getting used to it. I like to play as this faction. I want to have Germany united, maybe recreate the Holy Roman Empire. It's not an easy thing, especially on Iron Man when you can't reload. What happened? Well, I don't even see it. It wasn't Bohemia. Bohemia was a bit of a beast the time before. It wasn't Poland either. It was... it doesn't even exist. It's an empire that basically was... I'm not sure who started it. It was like Carpathia, I think, was it? And they had all of this and went back all the way up to here. It was crazy. It was larger than the Byzantine Empire. Byzantine Empire basically had a lot of this territory. They converted Lombardy. Lombardy is, they're a German group, but they took over Italy probably a couple hundred years before. Probably about 200 years before. I'm not sure when the Lombards actually came in. I'm not sure if they're the ones that gave the killing blow to Italy, to the old Roman Empire, the Western Roman Empire, or if they came in afterwards after it was basically all sacked and run down. But they are the power in Italy. They are, they're Catholics. It does say Italian in places. I think that's, it also says Lombard pretty far down, all the way to the end. I think there's Greek, Lombard. I don't know. I mean, I'd have to look at the, what is the faction? Or sorry, what is the, he's Lombard, so it's all going to be Lombard eventually. Okay, so it was a little bit older of an older man. He was in his 50s, this guy's 46. Made him a genius, lustful so he can have kids. He starts off wounded, that was a way of getting him to be a little bit younger. He's a skilled tactician, he's not a great fighter. If the more traits that you add, the more score, the older your guy gets. So I don't need a 70-year-old man to start with who's going to die right away. So he's 46, he's wounded, hopefully that'll clear up. If not, I'll have to restart. So I start off in a bit of a, like, I'm a duke, start off in a bit of a advantageous position. So if I check him out, he has two counties of his own, Bamberg and Würzburg. Duchy of Franconia, that's his. So I've got 1, 2, 3 vassals and two counties of my own. What I like to do, I don't even think... Oh, I do have... Oh, nice chancellor to start. You go fabricate claims. Put them in Thuringian. And... yeah, get a Cassius Belli. I don't know how to properly say it. Cassius Belli. Whatever it is. A CB on this guy right here. And then... this is his vassal to him. So, take this out. He will actually take Plowin over. And then just get another CB on there. So, they have to fabricate a claim on Plowin. After that, So this is also my vassal, yeah. Why isn't it? Sometimes it says your vassal. Your spy master. This guy is my vassal. He's got to be. Maybe not. Because that's part of my duchy. Let's go de jure. Yeah, it's part of my de jure duchy. And Nassau is not, actually. Okay. So this is... I should have a claim already on that. Who is his... Oh, it's right with... yeah, with Charlemagne himself. So it's hard to argue. But doesn't mean I can't make a claim on... A fabricated claim and then go to war with him right there. Okay, no heir to my dynasty. Yeah, so I'm in a bit of a dangerous situation. I don't even have a steward. Hopefully I can get 13. Not terrible. I've also come to, like, research. The research that I've been doing, I think it's been a bit wasteful. It's basically just a way of spreading out what research you have in the capital to other counties. So it's not always necessary. It's a pretty damn good marshal. Train troops. Put them in Würzburg. Make all these guys. Okay, so study technology. Well, it's probably just Byzantine Empire. I think everyone's Catholic. I don't think I have to worry about that. So, I don't know. What does the Pope? How does the Pope feel about me? So I do have to work. Be concerned about how the Pope feels about me at all, anytime. So, minus 10 because of lustful, plus 15 because of state diplomacy. So, with my genius, I'm pretty average across the board. I'm good at martial, not great. And direct liege is Charlemagne himself, who is... Well, I've seen him better. He was 25 when I've seen him before for martial. So, he's pretty good. Wow. If you start off as a woman and marry him, wow, you would have a lot of power. Especially through your children. I don't know if that would make you take over. Strange, but we need to get him married immediately, and he needs to get kids immediately. One thing I've really, starting this position, I've really come to learn, you need to get allies. They're so important. I was trying to say Carpathia was a beast, and they were always, they're right against my border, and they were just, I had an epic war with them. I actually won, even though I was outnumbered quite a lot. I won by the skin of my teeth, and that probably had to do with a lot of my money that I had. I had over 600 gold at the time, and I was able to hire the White Company, which added 4,500 soldiers, and they're pretty decent. A lot of heavy infantry right there. Oh, 90 heavy cavalry, too. That helps. And that's what I'll be doing, is going heavy cavalry, like traditional medieval. That's a very powerful charge. Okay, so what do I want? Well, first thing I can do is get married. I gain 10 piety. Duke Bertrand's opinion of King Carl. Why would my opinion of my king go up by 15 just for getting married? Interesting. Well, we need to get married. So it means I've got... There's not too many people when the game first starts out. But you know what? It's very possible to get married to a princess, even though I'm just a duke. And that's always awesome. So there's like maybe 20 women you can get married to. There's Princess of Lombardy, Gaberga. Brave, charitable, cruel, trusting. She's not bad, actually. It's not terrible, but... It would be nice to have, well, I'm also part. It really doesn't matter until I'm independent to get these alliances. But right now, I mean, that's pretty big, marrying a princess of one of the larger, more powerful kingdoms in Europe at the time. Well, at least Christian Europe. Probably third overall. Okay, so, and every time I play, Middle Francia gets devoured by West Francia. This guy always dies, the king. He's Charlemagne's brother. And they're at odds with each other. He's 18 years old. He's pretty young. And Charlemagne is 26, so he's 8 years older than his brother. What's this? Ruler unmarried. Well, title loss and succession. No heir to my dynasty. You can press de jure. Okay, we can press on mains right away. I wonder if I can do that. I don't really have that large of an army. Let's let it fill up. Because when you put a marshal down training troops, you're unraised... Your max total goes up. Okay, so let's start this. I'm pretty sure she'll say yes to the marriage. Now, I think Gaberga gets married to Charlemagne if you don't marry her. Yes, it's everyone's concern. One gold? Seriously? One gold isn't going to be much. Give me prestige. And no, why would this be yes, it's everyone's concern? We can collect the royal aid duty to pay the ceremonies. No, people respect wealth. Well, one gold is nothing, so we're going to go with 100 prestige. Except you're suggesting that Duke Bertrand and Princess Gaburga get married. Okay, so I fulfilled that ambition. Lots of others. Don't become king of East Francia. Every time I do it, the guy gets the stress trait. And he doesn't actually live that long. So, we want to have a son. It says become paragon of virtue, piety of 500. Well, if he lives, it's quite possible. Let's just go with having a son. Okay, so it's going to save at twice a year, which I find a little bit irritating. And the longer the game goes on, the longer it takes to save. So the first 100 years, it didn't take that long. But around 900 and afterwards, it does start to take longer. Lords of Papacy, Limited Crown, Pope Stephen Latium. I don't know what the heck that was about. So there are laws within my... Ooh, centralization. Let's bring that up immediately. There's a few things I'd like to change, but centralization, one more domain size. We are currently at 2 out of 3, which is obvious. So with my high fertility, I very well should be able to have a son pretty quickly. How old is she? She's 24, so... Yep, she's in her prime for giving birth. So he's declared... We've declared war in Bavaria, my king has. King Charlemagne. He's not an emperor yet. I've never seen him actually create something fantastic. He does take over Middle Francia. I've seen him take over Saxony. More than that, I don't think Charlemagne really... I mean, this is my third game. I don't think I've ever seen him do much. Like, in reality, I think... Didn't he conquer Saxony? I think, didn't he invade northern Italy and then send help to the Pope when Lombards were threatening him? Yeah, in my last game, Lombardy took over all the papacy. Okay, so we already have... our spy took some tech. Oh, very nice. We can fill this whole one up. Let's just go with military organization. That's where I always like to go. Now, unfortunately... I mean, it's nice to have more retinues and better supply and a little bit more morale for your armies. Unfortunately, you cannot go into the pagan lands unless you want to take heavy attrition until you get to fourth. And I don't think I've gotten there yet. That will be probably around the year 1050 if I keep on track. Maybe, yeah, around 1050, maybe even 1100. I haven't quite gotten there. No heir to my dynasty. So what's the troop situation like? It's April. It's filling up. And your marshal can actually train, get it so he recruits faster, 50% faster. But just having him there, the levy size plus 50%, levy reinforcement rate plus 100%. So it's already 100%. You can get him, there's a special event that he has a chance of getting levy reinforcements, 32% .04 every year. You get another 50%. So trust me, I've had to use that so often to increase my personal domain army size. And it's not demesme. I've even asked on the boards. It's domain. It's French. Demesme. I was watching somebody on the... do some explanation of the game. This DLC, the Charlemagne DLC. And on the official channel, too. Paradox Extra, I think it was. And he called it demesme. It's not. They're domain. My liege, since I arrived in Würzburg, okay. Undergrounds, I believe, fame, fortune. Okay, so he's increased levy reinforcements by 50%. So we're almost up to the maximum, less than 100. Once we get that, we'll have over 1,000. That should be enough to hit mains and take it. That's a de jure part of the duchy. The old wound is finally healed, leaving a pretty grotesque scar behind. So yeah, obviously he was wounded in battle. He gets scarred, which gives him more prestige per month, 0.10. Okay, time to start having kids. Hit this wife hard every day. Oh, come on, dude. Maybe I need to give her... she's terrible at stewardship. I don't want to make her... There's some changes. I'm going to give her a high almoner. It's a title. Not a title, it's... What do you call it? Honorary title, yeah. Well, let's see what it is. The handing out of alms was an integral part of rulership with their religious observance. The one responsible for this task is a very important personage. Okay, so that's what I gave her. Make her happy. But, We are at war. I should have done this before we went to war. I forgot. First thing I like to do every time you get a new king is to go on a pilgrimage. You can't do that if you're at war. It's pretty cheap. 5 gold. 5 99 gold. Also, you can also borrow 300 gold from Jewish merchants. But when you pay it back, it's 350. There's no interest as far as I know. Problem is that people of the church, it's a minus 10%, 10, not percent, minus 10 opinion with people in your church. Charlemagne doesn't particularly like me. Don't know why. Well, if I have a son, he's a great teacher. I've done that before. The rise of the Shia, that was fast. Usually that doesn't happen for a while. The schism at the heart of Islam dates back to the earliest days. The majority of Sunnis have long persecuted the followers of Ali, the Shias, forcing them into hiding. The partisans of Ali took to his descendants for leadership, but they are forced to keep their ancestry secret. Now, though, the Shias are mobilizing their strength behind a boy whom they claim to be Ali's rightful heir and imam. Other Islamic jurists claim that the boy is clearly a fraud, but to his followers, he is the person they have been waiting for, and now they flock to his banner. Ha, the fools fight among themselves. Well, you know, that's good, because the Abbasid Empire is a beast. In my last game, the Byzantines actually lost a couple counties, and then they fought them again, and gained a couple counties, and then they fought them again, and it was a stalemate. They had a white peace declared. Byzantine also empire was all up here, and the bottom part of Italy. They were pretty powerful. The Abbasids, though, they usually go take all this, and parts of here, some parts of India. So they're a bit of a monster themselves. I wish that they would break up. They're just too powerful to have running around independent, like one big independent nation like that. Once this war is over, we're going to go on a pilgrimage. Pilgrimages can bring... Most of the time they don't really give you much, but sometimes they give you a lot. Like I had a... I think it was Brilliant Tactician. It was some kind of warrior king. But he was also Craven. So I'm like, damn, that sucks. But it put him on a pilgrimage, and he ran into some guys on the road, and I was able to fight them, and it made him brave. So he got the brave trait from that, and took away the craven trait. So it's very weird to be under the rulership of somebody that actually has you go to war. You also have to keep in mind, leading troops in Niederbayern, I'm right here. I have no choice about that. I have no control of it either. So if my guy gets injured or dies, that's completely out of my hands. I mean, I could lose the game. The game can end right now if I die in battle. So hopefully not. Hopefully this will be over with. Our side is losing. Son of a... Well, his name is Duke Bertrand of Franconia. That's the Duchy, Franconia. And the house is von Argenau. I think it's cool. Okay, so what do we do? I'm pretty sure we have enough. Yeah, we have... Let's try this. We still declare war. Go to war while I'm out leading troops for the king. So, de jure, claim on mains. Hopefully this will go okay. Let's raise the forces. Got a fair-sized army for one county. That's not much. 6 soldiers from Nassau. That's my... Does he even like me? Just 9 opinion. This guy is 68 opinion. This guy is 20... 31 opinion. What happened? Major revolt. Middle Franconian revolt. That's not against us. That's against Middle Franconia. Or Middle Francia. Keep saying Franconia because that's my... It will soon be my kingdom, but I'll convert it over to Germany at some point. Okay, so who do we have leading this force? 13 is not the worst. Let's see how this goes. They're running, so obviously the AI does not think that they have a chance. Let's try to get them. I don't like to go across a major river. It's a pretty big malice that you get hit. And your levies, they... every month that they're raised from your vassals, it's minus 1 opinion. We still have to go over a river, but not a major river, so... And, looks like we're winning quite well. Centerfold is the flanks. The flanks won the day. Where is he going? Back home, I bet? Mains, yeah. pretty good. Just have to finish him off. He's in prison. I don't know if we... I don't think we took him prisoner. Oh, fate smiles upon me. My wife, Gaberga, is pregnant. So even if I die fighting, I'll either take over as a woman or a daughter, as my daughter or my son, whoever was somewhat secure. Okay, so they're not giving up. We'll have to keep going and take county, Maine's county capital. Oh, this is very nice. They already approved limited crown authority law. That usually doesn't happen so quickly. It usually takes a couple decades. This still has not been approved. I want more centralization so I can have another domain. Who is this? Sorbia. What? Oh, picked up a war with Sorbia. Fighting Charlemagne. This little two-county kingdom? Okay. I don't think that they're going to win, but against us. They can bring in our allies. I don't even know what the war is about. Brandenburg, conquest of Plauen. Oh, okay, so they want one of my future counties, which we will not allow. Buggers. So yeah, this... I'm going to continue to play this Let's Play until we finish. I don't even know if we're going to win against Bavaria. Right to the end, and hopefully from there I'll have a nice big solid Germany in which I can play... Europa Universalis 4. Now, the reason why I couldn't continue is because there was no saves left from the previous playthrough. It sucks. I had stopped it for a couple months because we just had a new child. It's just too much going on at home. And, well, it was 100%. So now, I mean, I don't... Things are starting to settle down at home. I mean, I'm not doing too well health-wise lately, but... Okay, so, no colors change, but... The ruler doesn't even change. However, he now is my vassal. And I will dismiss the levies. And it takes it 1 month to heal, or repair the opinion for every number there. So 4 minus 4, it will take 4 months to fix that. Alright guys, I'm going to end the video here. Plan to take over these two spots at some point in time. And from then... I'll start picking away at everybody else around me, and when the chance comes, it will probably be my grandson at earliest that will declare independence, maybe even my son declare independence, and we will become our independent Franconia. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again.